My name is Jeff. I serve as community evangelist here at The Grid, and today I'm going to be giving you an update on what our mobile teams are up to, and in particular, our iOS team and what they've been developing, which is the first of its kind, a mobile app that will be able to build a website from a mobile device, which is pretty cool. We are going to be bringing in content from today from three different elements. We're going to be bringing in social media content. We're going to be bringing articles and interest stories off the web. And then we're also going to be bringing in original content that would be photographs or videos that belong to, in this case, myself. This particular website is really centered around my love of iPhone photography. As they say, the best camera is the one that you always have with you. And now I'm able to actually not only take those images that I shoot on the iPhone and build a site from it, but I'm also able to do it on that same mobile device, which is pretty epic. So let's get started. We're first going to launch the Stellar app. Stellar is just another social community platform that's for visual storytellers. I'm going to select this story, and I'm just going to share this to the grid. And we'll walk through all these steps and how that happens and where this stuff goes. From here, this dialog box will open up and you can give a description or you can just go ahead and share it right to the grid. Now, as I share to the grid, you might notice there might be some notifications coming in from the AI letting me know that the content is ready. And what that means is that the content is ready for me to share to the web once I'm inside the web app itself. The next thing we're going to do is bring in some original content. And since this is all dedicated to iPhone photography, I'm just going to share some of my latest iPhone photography work and just talk a little bit about the lenses that I'm using. In this case, I'm using a lens called Moment, and just going to talk a bit about it. Okay, from here, we are going to open up then into some articles. One thing I've chosen in my grid layout is I wanted it to be editorial driven and editorial style. So it's more of a newsfeed layout. Because of my occupation, I'm always on the road, I'm traveling. This is a great way for people to kind of keep up to date on what I'm doing by following me. And by going to my grid site, they're able to kind of see my daily updates because I'm able to make updates on my mobile phone, whether I'm in an airplane, on a bus or in a car or a very remote area. So that makes it very useful for me in my marketing, and it's a great tool to have as part of my my marketing plan. So here I'm gonna hit the share button. I'm gonna select the grid. Again, I'm not gonna give it any description. I'm just gonna publish that to a post. And you can edit the post later on down the road if you want to, and I can show you how to do that. And last but not least, pretty cool 2015 winning photographs, all shot on iPhone. Some pretty talented photographers out there. And again, I'm gonna leave this description blank and just publish that article. It's gonna pull all that metadata in and that in one of those images. So makes it pretty cool, pretty easy. So right now we've actually entered in, you can enter as much content as you want. In this case, we've entered in four separate posts, four separate articles to share. And now we're going to go into the app and we are going to build that website and publish that website. This is the first thing you're going to see in the interface, which is all your posts. I kind of like to refer to it more in my terms like a light box. And in here you'll see these are all my posts that I have created that are either original content, photographs, blog posts, or republished posts from elsewhere on blogs, interest stories, or my social media content, whether it be Twitter, Instagram. So it kind of gives you a little bit of view here. So if you pinch it together, it kind of makes it bigger. You can kind of see more. If you want to just see one, kind of in this feed, just zoom out. All the content that you have gathered. It's very responsive. The guys have done an amazing job of building something that's very fluid in design and has a lot of ease about it as well. So the first thing I'm going to show you a little bit here is just going back to the four panel here so I can show the top four posts that I had collected earlier. And from here, there's just some more information regarding our sites, our posts, and our feed. There's also a feedback button. But what I'm going to do now is go to this section, and I'm just going to show you in the way I have designed my website. It's more of a news feed. One thing I'm able to do is actually just keep a starred post at the top, which would be my header, because like in a news feed, typically as I feed to it, the next post would go to the bottom. But if I want to keep something at the very top, I just select that. And as you can see, it grayed out that particular post there on the winners of the 2015 Photography Award. If I don't want that to be selected, I just hit that button again. From here, you can trash a post, and you can also edit the post, whereas you can do blog posts and write from there. As soon as you want to publish something, I'm just going to select these four articles, or these four posts, and I'm going to publish. And publishing is pretty much the easiest part here. As a founding member, you get up to 7 websites, which is a tremendous value for what that is. So here are all my 7 websites. But the particular site that I'm going to publish to is my iPhone site. And in here, I'm just going to, again, just select that. And it's going to publish those posts right to my website. It's that easy. And go back over here and just kind of show you again from the site section. If I'm trying to find a site or try to find a particular post, I'm able to go through here and just look at the post on each one of my websites. So for this particular website, here are all the posts for those. And if I want to go back to one more here, I can look at all the posts from here. Again, just all the posts from that particular website. Again, if I want to delete a website, it's pretty easy. I just go here in the bottom left-hand corner. I can hit delete site, and if I want to unpublish a post, that's easy again. Select the post that you want to unpublish, and down at the bottom you can unpublish that post, and that will remove your post from your website. Now, if I want to look at that website in particular, it's very easy. Just go to your sites, and there you'll see the website link button. Well, as you can see, my website is finished in just under 3 minutes. The post that I start is the very first one you're seeing. And based on the layout spectrum, I chose more of a minimal layout design, more of a news feed. And our AI is creating harmony and rhythm with the content that I've given it. You know, content dictates form, and the AI has chosen the colors and the typeset based on the content that I've given it. And in the next update, I'll be able to show you a bit more of how we how I can fine tune that, or how you can fine tune that layout design and spectrums all within a slide of a button. This kind of gives you a little context of how these work. These were brought in from my social media, and they're actually just a link back to my social media platform to get more followers if that is your case, or just to show your work. And so, the AI is creating. It's still just a baby. It's learning. It's growing. It's making mistakes. It's making itself better. And we know there's a lot of obstacles left, but we also understand that we have an opportunity to build something from the ground up. And we're not taking a traditional approach to this. And we're inspired to lead, not follow. So we thank you so much to all of our founding members for your support. And if you need to reach out to us in any way, feel free through our social media on Twitter. You can also reach out to us through email at support@thegrid.io. Thanks a lot and have a great day.